students, wishing you all a very lovely good morning. So you all know that we are on the chapter of accounting equation, and we are discussing transactions one by one, that what transactions are covered and what is their effect on the accounting equation. Accounting equation, also called balance sheet equation, is the foundation for all accounting terms, and we are following the method of equation, the left hand side and right hand side method, that is assets is equals to liabilities plus equity. So before starting, let us first go through the learning objectives of the chapter. 1. Understand the meaning of accounting equation. Know the components of accounting equation. Know the meaning of assets, liabilities and capital. Identify the effect of a business transaction. Appreciate the effect of change. Understand the usefulness of accounting equation. So these are the learning objectives for which we are doing this accounting equation chapter. So as you know that this chapter has some terminology also, new terms which we have to cover. So in today's topic, we have to cover accounting equation, dual aspect, owner's equity and outsider's equity. Before proceeding with the question, with the numerical which we have started yesterday, so let us once review about the Nayasa company whose transactions we are going through. So we all know that Nayasa is a kitchenware homemade plastic company, and it has a collaboration with many other chain stores like Big Bazaar, Walmart, D-Mart, Max, Spencer, Reliance, Vishal Mega Mart, Spar, Metro. It means you can see the products of Nayasa in these stores and one can buy them at the reasonable prices. So they are associated with it. So let us first go through the transactions which we were doing yesterday. So first of all, we have started with paid rupees 1000 to creditors for merchandise purchased. So you all know yesterday we had a value of merchandise with 13,500 less 3000, that is 10,500. Merchandise was sold for 4000, but it cost 3000. So in that way, we have cash is equals to 32,000, furniture 10,000, merchandise 10,500, debtors 4000, creditors 5000, capital 51,500. Now here again, 1000 is paid back to the creditors. Creditors are paid back, it means creditors will be going to reduce. Paid back, therefore there is effect on cash also. Then it becomes 31,000 in cash, 10,000 in furniture, 10,500 in merchandise and 4,000 in case of debtors, because it was sold on credit basis. And on other side, we have creditors now left with 4,000 and capital as 51,500. So 55,500 is balancing on the both sides. Okay, now the next transaction, that is transaction number 8, received cash from a debtor 1000 whom a sale on credit was made earlier. So we have debtors of 4000 with us to whom we have made the sale of merchandise. So they have given us 1000 rupees. Now debtors will decrease. They have given us 1000, it means debtors will now decrease. And we are receiving cash, so cash will increase. Received cash from a debtor 1000 whom a sale on credit was made earlier. This is an example of collection from debtors. This transaction is an exchange of one asset for another. The effect is on one side of the equation, that is asset side only. Cash is increased by 1000. Furniture remains same. Merchandise remains same. Debtors will be decreased by 1000. But there is no effect on liabilities and capital side. And the total will remain 55,500 as it was earlier. So few transactions have effect on both sides and few transactions have effect on one single side only. Now let us go back to the question as which we were doing yesterday. So I have told you that Samrat started business with cash of 1 lakh. Now cash will increase 1 lakh, and when a person brings cash, so his capital also increases. He brings cash, it means he invested money in business, and that investment is called capital. So on one side cash increases, other side capital increases. Next, he did purchased goods in cash. So in this way, purchased goods in cash of 50,000. So goods will increase of 50,000 and cash will reduce of 50,000. Plus 50,000 minus 50,000. Plus minus cancel, it becomes zero. Then there is no effect on asset side and liability side, and they will remain 1 lakh as it is. Now the next transaction, that is purchase goods from B Furnitures of 20,000. So now one more asset is added, that is 20,000. We will add it on asset side. Now it is purchased from B Furnitures. So it means we have not paid any cash. So in this way we will also add it on liability side, because we have not paid anything. Means we have to pay it later, then it becomes our creditor. So it becomes 1,20,000 on asset side, and on other side again 20,000 of liability and 1 lakh of the capital. Next transaction is sold goods costing 25,000 for 35,000. Now there is a difference of 10,000, and that 10,000 is profit and it should be added in capital. The difference of 35,000, selling price minus cost price, that is profit of 10,000, we will add in capital, because it's a profit and all, it is always added in capital. 25,000 goods we have sold, so we will deduct 25,000 from goods and we will add 35,000 to the cash, because we have sold it for cash purpose. Now our asset side become 1,30,000, liability side 20,000, and capital 1,10,000. So both sides 1,30,000 each. Now the last transaction, paid to B Furnitures in cash. Now this is paid to B. Now you are paying B Furnitures in cash. What was the amount of B Furnitures? It was 20,000. So we are paying them in cash now. First of all, 20,000 will be deducted from cash. Furnitures from liability side also we will deduct, because now we have no more creditors to pay. Liability will remain same as it is. So here assets become 1,10,000, liabilities become zero, and capital also 1,10,000. So there is a balance between both sides with a result of net effect of 1,10,000 on both sides. And now we will discuss about the nature of accounting equation. An accounting equation always holds true with every change that occurs due to transaction entered into. It is because of this reason that it is based on the dual aspect concept of accounting. A transaction may affect either both sides of the equation, as you have seen in the practical approach, by the same amount, or one side of the equation only, by both increasing or decreasing it by equal amounts. Now, transactions from the accounting equation viewpoint can be divided into two parts. Transactions affecting two items, transaction affecting more than two items. So we have two parts where transaction affects two items, where transaction affects more than two items. So we will discuss both these two parts in detail. So we know that relationship known as the accounting equation can be presented in equation form as given in four ways. We can write assets is equals to equities or total claims. Liabilities is equals to assets minus capital. Assets is equals to liabilities plus capital. Capital is equals to assets minus liability. And the balance sheet equation can be presented in equation form as given below. So let us have a look at the balance sheet here. So preparing of balance sheet adds somehow help us to get a balanced equation on one side, while we can discuss it in the form of a summarized statement also. So on liability side, we have capital, loans, current liabilities, creditors, outstanding expenses, and on asset side, we have fixed assets, land and building, machinery, stock, debtors, cash and bank. But both sides are matching. It means assets are always equals to liabilities. So this is our approach in accounting equation as well, that assets should always be equal to liabilities. Now let us first discuss transactions affecting two items. As the title suggests, these are those transactions that affect two items of the accounting equation or balance sheet. Transactions affecting opposite sides are increase in asset and increase in liability. Transactions such as credit purchases, purchase goods from Ram on credit. It will increase credit of goods. It will increase the amount of goods and also the liability because you have purchased. Next is decrease in liability, decrease in asset. So one effect was asset and liability both increases. Other effect is liability and asset both decreases. Transaction of payment to a creditor. Now if we pay to a creditor, cash decreases because of payment. Creditor decreases because that person is now no more your creditor. So it decreases liability and also reduces asset side, cash or bank. Other than these, we also have increase in asset and increase in owner's equity. Introduction of capital, bringing more cash in the business. So cash is increasing and also capital is increasing. Last is decrease in owner's capital, decrease in capital, decrease in asset. Drawings. So what are drawings? You all know, amount withdrawn by the business for personal use. So if he withdraws amount, it means cash decreases and liability also decreases. Now the business has no more money to pay back to the owner of the business. Now we have transactions affecting same side but in opposite direction. So in this we have two cases. First is increase in one asset, decrease in another asset. So one side error is there, one side adjustment is there. On one side only an asset is increased, other asset is decreased. Suppose cash purchases. So goods are coming, goods are increasing, cash is going, cash is decreasing. So in this way, what we have here, that debtors increase one asset, goods and cash or bank respectively, and decreases another asset, cash or bank and debtors. That is plus and minus on the same side. So if addition and subtraction is on the same side, then there is nil effect. After that, decrease in one liability, increase in another liability. Settlement of creditor. Now we are paying back to a creditor by issuing a bill. So what happened? When you are paying back to a creditor, creditor reduces, but your liability of bill become due and again a new liability arises. So here we can say that transactions affect either asset side or liability side. So this was the second type of transactions. Now the third type of transactions affecting more than two items. Some transactions affect more than two items of the accounting equation or a balance sheet. For example, when a sale is made in cash for 30,000, I have made a sale and I have received a cash of 30,000. So, but the amount which I incurred in the beginning, that is its cost was 25,000. So now 30,000 minus 25,000, I have a profit of 5,000 here. So cost of goods 25,000, I will reduce from stock 25,000, goods reduces 30,000, I will add in cash, and 5,000 of profit I will add in capital. Thus it has effects on more than two items, cash, goods and capital. More than two items. So we can say here, honor's capital increased by the profit and decreased by loss. So this is very important that whenever there is a profit, capital of the owner of the business increases, but when there is a loss, capital of the owner of the business decreases. Now we have three golden rules to remember to do our sums properly. First is debit the receiver, credit the giver. Try to understand. Debit the receiver, credit the giver. Ram paid to Shyam 5000. Who is receiving here? Ram is receiving. And who is paying here? Credit the giver. Who is giving? Shyam is giving. So what we will say here, Ram is receiving 5000 from Shyam. So it means Ram is the receiver and Shyam is the giver. So we will always debit Ram and credit Shyam. Next is debit what comes in, credit what goes out. Buy goods for 20,000. Purchase goods for 20,000. Goods are coming in the business. Debit what comes in. Whatever you are receiving, debit the same. Credit what goes out. What is going out of the business? Cash is going out. So we have to credit the cash here. Debit all expenses and losses. Now what you have to do? You have to debit all expenses and losses. Like paid electricity bill, paid rent, right? Now there is a loss of advertisement. So all are debited. So all we put on debit side because they are our expenses. And we credit all incomes and gains because it increases our capital. Credit means increase, debit means decrease. So expenses decreases our capital, so we debit them. And incomes increases our cash, so we all credit incomes and gains. Okay, now we will go with the procedure, how to prepare accounting equation. First of all, now you all know as we are done many examples till now. So first of all, we analyze the transaction, that how many items are included in it, assets, liabilities, capital, revenue, expenses. So we categorize each and every item first. Then we decide what side it is affecting, asset side or liability side, which item it is affecting, one side item or both sides item. It is affecting only cash, only furniture, only bank, or it is affecting liabilities and capital also. So first of all analyze the effect of the transaction, then we record such an effect on the relevant side, and in the last we balances the equation. So now, procedure is all clear to you. So you have been doing this with practical approach with lots of examples. For more clarity of the accounting equation, do refer the given link. Also answer the following questions. Give fundamental accounting equation. Give two basic purposes of accounting equation. What value is involved in preparing accounting equation? What is accounting equation? Give the transaction that will increase an asset and decrease another asset. What is the effect of transaction on accounting equation? Explain the terms assets, equities or liabilities. So now all of you are in a state that you can solve the illustrations of your book. So you people go through the PDF, open the PDF, see the illustrations there. You are able to get through the different points in the illustrations, different transactions in the illustrations. First of all, just go through what is the transaction, which item it is affecting. It is affecting both sides or a single side. How many items we have to record and on which side. Only then the equation will be balanced. Thank you.